said, a fairly sedate pace. Now some more pushing and shoving. Ejegehu Dibala just giving a teammate a bit of a shove as she moved to the front. And that's really what I was talking about. This 5,000 metre mark has been reached. 16 and a half minutes, 33 minute pace. And that's not good enough, particularly for Dibala, Ejegehu Dibala, the first one to really, well, to be honest, she barged herself to the front. And now, look at this, she just slowed down again. I don't really see the sense in that. Back with us, Brent.
I'm just plugged in, Stevie. And there's a fall there, but Ida Johnson's gone. She suddenly picked herself up and gone. And also the African champion, the Ethiopian Tufa, who's favoured in this race, is now way off the back. So a tumble there as they were jogging for position, trying to move around the field. And suddenly there's a little bit of acceleration picks up. But Benita Johnson, who was running a very, very quiet race, now finds herself in the middle of an incident. Tufa also trying to catch up. There they are in the middle of the group. They're too close together. Down goes Benita Johnson. Down goes Tufa of Ethiopia. She gets her shoe on the back. I imagine that meets with Steve Cram's approval, because she got on pretty quickly there. And there she goes, down the back straight now. She's determined to feature in this event.
She did well. And she's not only got her shoe on quickly, she's got herself back in the race very quickly without expending sort of energy you'd normally expect. But they are running at this slow pace. Fukushi, who went to the front, because now what's wrong with Tirunes Dibaba? Holding her stomach there, she's now 10 metres adrift of the field. And all the rumours kicking around that she's not in great shape look to be coming to fruition now. Tirunes Dibaba, let's keep an eye on this. She's the athlete at the back of the field, the pre-race favourite, the defending champion. This title has never been successfully defended. Ethiopia won it the last four occasions. Dibaba herself winning it last time round. World champion over 5,000 metres previously as well. And struggling.
Well, just before the race, her agent spoke to a friend of mine and said that she might be worried about her sister. She might not win this one. She's worried about her sister there. She's desperately trying to take on water. That's a very bad sign. But we do talk about the Ethiopians training at high altitude in Addis Ababa and sometimes having difficulty in adapting to humid conditions at sea level. But there's the champion, detached from the group. She wasn't the Ethiopian athlete that fell. She wasn't involved in that incident. She's obviously struggling. This is, begins to explain why we've only seen her run one race this summer. We expected well, she came in as the favourite, but some of the rumours and some of the comments, and now I understand why her agent was saying that she might have trouble with her sister Ejigo Dibaba.
Another 78 second lap, so despite all the pushing and the shoving and everything else, they have picked the pace up. And to be honest, Tirunes Dibaba looks as though she's rallied a little bit. She took a bit of a drink on board, as previously holding her stomach, but looks as though she's moving a little bit better. Can she get herself back into this race? But that's not the sort of thing that you want to have happen to you in the middle of the race anyway. The defending champion really struggling, holding her stomach once more as she goes down that back straight. She's doing her best to get back involved in this, but it doesn't look good as her teammate at the front, young Nestor Tufa, wearing 4.17, just without really forcing the pace. I don't know if she's seeing what's going on behind, whether she's aware of the fact that Tirunes Dibaba is struggling or not. There are big screens at either end, and I haven't seen any of the athletes really looking up. There's Dibaba, you can just see, trying to get back, and this time she does look up, the leader, Tufa, looking up at the screen, seeing that her teammate, Dibaba, maybe just getting back onto this group here.
Two athletes in first and second, the two athletes we saw have problems with their shoes, tripping over, having their shoes detached, but both of them now very much back in the race. And here comes Tirunes Dibaba. Well, this is a bit over-exuberant. She's obviously recovered from whatever it was that was ailing her there. She got some water, which I'm not sure she drank enough of that water to make such a difference. And the pace continuing at a relatively slow level means that the opportunity for Tirunes Dibaba, the reigning champion, the only athlete who's ever won the 5 and 10,000 metres in a major world championship. That was, she did that last time, 2005. And now she's accelerating through the field. Now she's back in the middle of the group. Just one pace, place ahead of Joe Pavey, but I just wonder what's going on out there.
Yeah, I wonder what Joe's making of all this. Sometimes if you just got your head down in the middle of the pack, you don't see all the comings and goings. Just every now and then see somebody shooting around the outside who you may normally expect to see at the front. And Joe just trying to keep out of trouble as much as anything else with his slow pace. They're still all bunching. Too far. Fukushi. Tim Smith of New Zealand, the tall figure. Blonde hair, just taking closer order. There's Joe Pavey, looking up at the screen. Just having a little look, see what's going on behind. Only one athlete cast adrift at the minute. Benita Johnson is at the back of the pack. But Tirunesh Dibaba has rejoined. Tufa, who had she had to step off and reshoe, she's rejoined. So, as you were in this women's 10,000 metre final.
Well, I think Tirunesh Dibaba is extremely lucky to be able to come back from such a big gap. And the only way she was able to do that was because nobody took the opportunity of moving the pace along. So Tirunesh Dibaba, the reigning champion, has gone through a really bad patch. We don't know quite what was wrong with her. You'd be very surprised if she comes home as strongly as she has done in the past, but we don't know. The two leaders have been in trouble. They lost their shoes at one point. Benita Johnson's been in trouble. She's been on the floor. Tirunesh Dibaba's been off the back of the group. So we've already had a drama as we watched number 262 stepping off the track. That cuts over of Belarus. So there, all things happening now in the women's 10,000 metres. The pace consistently just moving and just a shade faster. They were running 69 seconds, they're now running 67, 68 seconds. And Joe Tavey's taking closer order. She realises she's got to be in that leading group if she's going to do anything, moving wisely into that pack. This is a good performance from Joe Tavey. She's put herself in the right place. Nobody's made a serious move yet. That's going to happen soon. You can sense there's so many of them in the group. There's so much build-up going on. There's so much tension out there. Athletes looking at one another, using shoes, going up and down the field, falling down. We've had it all tonight.
Benita Johnson moving across, taking drinks. Incidentally, Evelyn Wambui, the Commonwealth silver medalist, she's taking a drink as well, but she's 10 metres adrift of the field, and she's struggling as well. She just she hasn't had anything happen to her. She's just going, starting to run a little bit more slowly. When Fukushi, who's definitely picked up the pace, the last couple of kilometres have been, well, the last three have been 318, 313, then 315, but they're now operating a little bit quicker than that. That was the quickest lap of the race, the previous lap, 76 seconds. And Kim Smith, isn't that interesting to see Kim Smith of New Zealand and Kara Goucher of the USA in second and third. Kim Smith, who's been there, she's 7.25, having a superb season, personal best, set over this distance, 31 minutes and 20 seconds. Oceana record over 3,000 metres in the Monaco Grand Prix race. 8.35, so that's good pace as well, as Joel Tavey just gets herself where she wants to be, behind the big names, behind the African and Kenyan athletes, the Ethiopian and Kenyan athletes you'd expect to take or be involved in the medal hunt. And Abby Legesse for the first time, just drifting to the front now. This is the first of the big names to really start to push on. Kim Smith goes to follow, and Abby Legesse for the first time stretches them out.
And I notice Joe Tavey looks up, so was Abby Legesse, and has decided it's about time she to respond. Joe Tavey running alongside the defending champion Dibaba, and Abby Legesse, just over five laps to go here, and Abby Legesse starts asking the questions. In second place, Tufa of Ethiopia, the African champion, then Ejigo Dibaba, who was third in the 5,000 metres and the 10,000 metres last time. And there, number 412, moving up on the outside, is Tirunesh Dibaba, the favourite, the pre-race favourite, the athlete who went through that really difficult patch. And Joe Tavey is just hanging on there, becoming a little bit detached as she sees five laps to go. Five laps is the kind of distance where we've seen Joe Tavey apply herself and run very, very hard, but Abby Legesse is now testing them. Tirunesh Dibaba responds very quickly there. Joe Tavey is in about seventh or eighth place and being tested all the time, but Tirunesh Dibaba surprising everyone with the way she's run this race and hanging on to Abby Legesse, and the gaps are opening. Joe's working hard there. Joe's still going strongly, moving into fifth, moving past into fifth place now, so that's timing. And his athletes to take 2,000 trouble. The athlete who had her shoe detached earlier, and Joe Pavey now in fifth place. Remember, she was fifth in the Olympic Games, but a medal beckons here for Joe Pavey. We know she's going to be brave. We know she's going to be strong. We know she's going to work as hard as she possibly can in the later stages. She's got chances here.
Well, it's Abby Legesse and Tirunesh Dibaba, two of the famous names. Abby Legesse, who famously broke the 5,000-metre world record, now running for Turkey. She broke that record in Bergen a couple of years back, 3 years ago, in Norway. But what about their Cara Goucher, Kim Smith and Joel Pavey? An American, a New Zealander and a British athlete. There's too far, something happened to her. She started limping and had to drop out. But Joel Pavey is getting herself onto the back of the group who are contending for the bronze medal. Cara Goucher, whose husband Adam Goucher is running in the distance events here for the USA. She'll be being cheered on by, well, the Americans have such a resurgence, of course. Dina Castor trying to get herself involved as well. But Joe Pavey now looks up at the screen, and I think she'll be amazed to see that the people she has for company, she'll know that these two are expected to be there, but I'm not sure she would have expected to see the likes of Kim Smith, Cara Goucher, Dina Castor, who's behind her, in contention for the medals. That will give her huge confidence, because Joe Pavey will think, these are people I think I can beat. These are people who I know well. There's Dina Castor. These are people who, when it comes to the last lap or two, I'm not going to fear. I'm going to just work hard and stay involved here. Abby Legesse and Dibaba, although they set and picked up the pace, just have a 5-6 metre lead on that little group of three containing Joe Pavey. Three laps to go.
Joe Pavey in a great position there. Just tracking him. Dina Castor's chasing Joe Pavey. There are six athletes clear. Joe's in fifth place. And I think there's a real serious medal chance for Joe Pavey. The race has gone just gradually faster and faster. Abby Legesse is asking all the questions down the back straight. Tirunesh Dibaba, the reigning champion, is in second place. And she's had an eventful route to get into that position. Quite amazing what's gone on in this race. And then Goucher of the USA, then Kim Smith of New Zealand, and then Joe Pavey. Now remember, 1,000 metres to go, 2.5 laps to go. Remember Joe Pavey. We've seen Joe apply herself in races over 1,000 metres and work so hard. She's prepared to go for it. There's a medal here beckons for Joe Pavey. She's got a great chance of doing it. If you asked her before the race, would she take this position coming up with 2 laps to go? She definitely would answer me yes. Joe moves into fourth place. The guts and determination of this young lady now moving into third place. And she shouldn't just give up on that, because things may even happen at the front. Abby Legesse, Dibaba, Joe Pavey in the bronze medal position with two athletes on her shoulder. But Joe's strong. 2 laps to go. She does that in training. She's striding out. She's looking perfect now. She's looking stronger at this point than she did 20 laps ago.
Well, what strength of mind that is from Joe Pavey. The easy thing to do at this stage is to sit and settle for a last lap sprint. But no, she's looked ahead. She's seen these two athletes. She knows how good they are, but she's thinking, they're not that far ahead. If I can get onto them, get them to break me away from these two behind, then the medal is assured. Just over 600 metres to go. She hasn't yet done that. She hasn't caught these two, and she hasn't broken the two behind her. But Joe Pavey is doing everything she can to take what would be her first medal in a global championship. She's won medal at the Commonwealth Games, has not won one in the World or Olympic Games, and that would be a huge achievement if she could. These two waiting, Tirunesh Dibaba sitting on the shoulder of Abby Legesse, but behind them there's a real battle, a battle royal going on between the USA and Great Britain at the minute for the bronze medal, and it's bringing them closer to these two.
And there goes the champion. An eventful route to 24 laps for the champion. She kicks on. Abby Legesse responds. Joe Pavey's battling into third place. And if it comes to a battle of guts and determination, Joe Pavey won't be giving up on it. She's in third place and edging further ahead in the back straight. Goucher, the American, in fourth. Kim Smith in fifth place. And Joe Pavey's working so hard. She's given everything. She's coming under pressure. But you know with Joe, she'll give you 100%. She'll give you more than she possibly do on occasion, as the champion looks majestic.
Nobody has ever defended this World Championship title. Tirunesh Dibaba is going to take the gold medal, and I have to say that Joe Pavey, I'd hate to say this if she's going to finish fourth, but Cara Gauter, who's got very good 1500 metre pace, has kicked away, and Jo Pavey's trying to fight again. It looks as though it's going to be fourth for her, but at the front, Tirunesh Dibaba wins her second world title. There were question marks, but she takes the gold medal for Ethiopia. Abi Legesse takes the silver. It's a brilliant bronze for Gauter, and a brave, brave run from Jo Pavey, which should have been rewarded with a medal. What a performance from Jo. Fourth again, out of the medals. Well, she'll be tired, but you know that will be nothing compared to how she feels now. She'll be so, so disappointed to have run a brilliant, brilliant race and to come away with nothing, to finish in the worst place possible, to finish fourth. It was a good race in the front in the end of Armand, recovering from the problem she had in the middle of the race, you may believe.